apologize because I have a cold right now, so, you know, if you see some tears, it's really just because my eyes are watering. So, I don't even know when I started coming here because it's pretty sporadic, but I came a little bit and, like, I liked to kind of be the face in the crowd that I didn't really want anybody to know me or ask who I was, mostly just because I came from a church that I was a regular member in because my parents went there, and I just never really felt like anybody really gave a hoot that I was there. And that was, like, 24 years, like, just growing up, and I don't know, like, so I didn't go to church for a long time, and when I found this church, like, I just really felt at home. And that's something I never felt in the church I was raised in, which I think is confusing to some people in my life. But so I knew that I needed to just get more connected because it's really easy to not come. It's just you and you don't know anybody, and to basically just not be accountable for being here, for growing. And so I enrolled in a group, and it was like really nerve-wracking. Like, I'm a big people person, but I was just like, oh my God, you know. So, you know, they talked about the first year that the deacon groups was going to start, which is a year ago. And I signed up and just was placed in a group in the little cheering section I had over there. And I just can't say how much of, like, a blessing it was. It was almost as if God, like, orchestrated all of us to just be in that spot at that time. And just the way that our personalities complement each other and the gifts that we have, and I just, like, have been so blessed with it. And I think for my personal story where God has really worked in my life is coming from that church where I just felt like, you know, like, we didn't have a community. Like, I went to church because my parents went there and I was supposed to be there every Sunday. And I hated it, really. And it got to the point where I only went to see my parents because that's the only time I saw them. And when I finally just, you know, made the adult decision to step away from that, it was rough, of course, but you know, I always knew that God loved me, and that wasn't an issue. Like, that never seemed to be the issue, and I'm really blessed that you brought up how God asked us to remember, because I had a bit of a rough upbringing, and when life is particularly rough, I decided to get a tattoo on the inside of my wrist that said remember, and it was specifically to remember that God loves me, and loves me exactly for who I am, and exactly the way that he made me, so it's an average. That God loved me. That was never a question. I always felt his presence in my life, and I felt that he was helping me. But what I wasn't so convinced about was that other people loved me, or that people I was in church with, or even that my parents really loved me. And joining the deepened group was just, I don't even know. Like, I was, I don't know what I'm going to say this morning. I don't know what I'm going to talk about. But I know that I went from just not wanting to be at church and not wanting to grow to, oh, it's Wednesday night, I gotta go. Like, I'm supposed to be at my group thing, you know, and just, like, to make that a priority. And yes, there was that effort that I had to choose to be there. Like, there's always a happy hour going on, or a baseball game, or something in the summer, or whatever. But making those steps and being with the people here who love me so much made it just easy. I wanted to be there. And since the deepen group is about going deeper together with your church and your community, and also with your relationship with God, like, I just have to say thank you to my group for being involved in my life. And I, even this week, so my wife Dana is here today, and her 30th birthday was Thursday, and it was like last minute, like, hey guys, like, we'd really love you to come celebrate with us. We're going to the living room, drink some wine or whatever. And I wasn't expecting anything, and everyone who could come was there. And it was like, oh my God, you're here. Like, oh my God, hi, thanks. You know, and just the fact that it's not, we don't just go to church on Sundays or have a group on Wednesdays where we sit and talk. Like, they're involved in my life and I'm involved in theirs. And we've done dinners together, we've done activities together. And I just, like, that's what community is. Like, it's not just sitting down on Wednesday night and hanging out. And we've made a point in our group to take it to the next level and to really be a part of each other's life. And, like, everything from birthdays to I can't find someone to watch the kids to, hey, do you somebody just want to grab a beer with me on Wednesday night? Like, it's just been such a blessing in my life to slowly start to learn that people really love me, and just as much as God does. And I couldn't have asked for That's my timer. It's been 5 minutes, which means I get sucked. Because there's just so much love here, and I really feel it's made such a difference in my life and helped me grow as a person and in my spirituality that it's just a great
program. Okay.